Okay. Welcome everyone for first virtual ADA conference. Let's talk about what we will see in the next ADA standard. As you know, the first ADA standard was released in 1983. Since then, the language continues to evolve constantly. For instance, the ADA 25 introduced an enhanced support of object-oriented programming, hierarchical modules, protected type, and so on. ADA 2005 brought multiple inherent support through interface types, containers in standard runtime library. And of course, ADA 2012 introduced contract programming and plenty of corresponding construct. ADA 2012 was released in December 2012, and technical corrigendum was published in February 2016. The document defines current language now. At this place, we will soon get a new standard. For now, it's called ADA 2020X, since release date is not yet known. ADA Reporter Group, IRG, is responsible for developer ADA standard. There is an IRG website where you can follow development process. Draft of the standard has been published there. ADA issues database and ARG minutes are also online. Current review is based on this date. The draft standard contains several separate section with a list of new feature. It includes more than a dozen items. We will review these changes in following order. Firstly, we will talk about parallel execution support, then about usability and expressiveness enhancement, including literal aggregates and iterators. Next, we will talk about runtime library extension. In the end, we will discuss ADA 2020X support in HNAT compiler. We get more and more processing power as hardware evolves. Today, this means we get more and more execution unit in our computers. GPUs and subprocessors provide hundreds of them. But we need a special program technique to use them effectively. ADA has support of concurrent programming from the start. We have tasks, protected types, entries, synchronous interfaces, and so on. All this work great for programmers with not so many large blocks. When each block solves its own problem. A good example is a typical database server architecture. This works not so good when many CPUs are solving one problem. It could be a function calculation over a huge array. The best way to do it is to split the problem to pieces and calculate them in parallel. This way, we have no synchronization between the begin of calculation and gathering partial results. To work this way, we need an ability to start a lot of logical threads. Each of these threads is part of surrounding task and inherits its attributes. The compiler then maps logical threads to available execution unit. The compiler also checks there is no deadlock and dead race. First construct that creates logical trees is a parallel block. It unions two or more statement sequences using caver AND as separator. Each of these sequences can be executed in parallel with others. Look at the simplified tree traversal code on the right picture. It will start two logical trees at each joint. As a result, each tree leaf will be persisted in a separate logical tree, regardless of tree form. As you see, number of logical tree can depend on processor data, not on the algorithm itself. Second way to create logical trees is a parallel loop. It also starts with a parallel caver. First example, just a sum of two arrays. Number of logical trees in this case will be equal to array length. We can restrict degree of parallelism by specifying number of chunks in brackets. Here's an example how process a big array using all available execution units. Note the last step of the computation is a reduce operation. We will discuss it right now. MapReduce is a nice programming model for processing big data set in parallel. Usually it calculates one single volume. It includes two steps. First step is map. It converts initial data into form suitable for aggregation. Second step is aggregation itself. Both steps benefit from parallel execution. Ada 2020X introduced a new attribute reduce. It performs, its prefix provides a sequence of values to be aggregated. The aggregate function is passed as argument. In other words, prefix presents map step, while argument specify function to be executed in reduce step. In the simplest form, prefix could be an array or container. Then the reduce will be performed on each element of the prefix. But prefix can also be a new special construct introduced in Ada 2020X. Its purpose is element generation. Syntax looks like a loop iterator. We will discuss it later when we talk about a new form of aggregators. Not a square brackets in the syntax. These are new for Ada. So how do we pass aggregate function? This could be a function with two parameters, or it could be a procedure that accumulates its first parameter. We can pass initial accumulator value as second argument of the attribute. All this will execute in parallel if you put parallel keywords in the prefix. On the right, there is an example of factorial calculation. But we must fulfill some condition in order to avoid problems during parallel execution. Fortunately, compiler can help us with this. Firstly, we must avoid deadlocks between logical trees. To check this, new aspect non-blocking was introduced. We can specify it on any subprogram or a package. For subprogram, compiler check for any blocking operation inside. When you put the aspect on a package, it applies to any subprogram of the package. Secondly, we must avoid data racing. If one thread reads some data while another thread reads, its result is unpredictable. Currently, we can use Pragma Pure with a package. This means any routine in this package doesn't have side effects. But wide use of the Pragma Pure is complicated. So new standard introduces aspect global. Using it, you can describe side effects in more flexible way. Its syntax isn't so simple as for non-blocking aspect. You can specify one side effect for reading and another for writing. Null mean no side effects at all, while all mean any side effect. You can also specify a list of concrete variables, packages, and access types. You can also use them in any combination. With these aspects, we can have more precise contracts for subprogram and let compiler check deadlocks and data racing. Consequently, we will get fast and safe program. Let's talk about new features related to usability and expressiveness. Some interesting changes we introduced in iterator. As you have seen before, it is possible now to iterate over container in parallel using several logical threads. You can do it in parallel loops, reduce operation, and in other construct. Of course, container should support this. You can add such support to your container by providing a new kind of iterator, parallel iterator. This is not so difficult to do. Iterator should be able to split its work to given number of chunks, return cursor for each chunk, and to guarantee that parallel work with this cursor will not cause a problem. There is another interesting way to iterate over container. In my opinion, it is simpler and uses less syntax sugar. And most importantly, it doesn't require that internal representation on elements inside the container matches the representation in the interface. If you remember, any other container iterator provides a pointer to a container element. This means any decoding or compressing on the fly isn't possible. You cannot store strings in UTF-8 encoding in a container if your interface uses a white string, for instance. But with procedure iterator, you can do it. Unfortunately, procedure iterator can only be used in loop statements. Compiler considers loop body as an anonymous subprogram. It takes subprogram parameters from loop parameters definition. Then compiler passes access to the subprogram into container iterator. The iterator itself calls a subprogram for each container element. This iterator doesn't have parallel form. You cannot use it for qualified expression, reduce operation, aggregates, and so on. Next one is rather simple enhancement. You can specify a condition after any array iterator. If condition doesn't hold, iterator skips the element. Here is an example of iteration over even numbers from 1 to 10. Of course, you can express it with a nested if statement, but it will be too long longer. We have some improvements for aggregates and literals. There is a new form of array aggregate association. We have seen this construct introduce attribute. There we used it to generate elements for reduce operation. In array aggregates, it uses to generate elements of aggregate. Here is an example of identity matrix. Another aggregate delta aggregates allow you to get the value of composite types based on an existing value by replacing some specified elements. They work for arrays as well as for records. This form could significantly shorten the text of contract. Now it is possible to use aggregates to fill a container. When writing container type, you need to specify the constructor of empty container and the routine for adding an items to the container. The compiler will use them when it encounters an aggregate of special kind. Notice square brackets are also used here. This allows you to distinguish an aggregate with a single element from an expression in parentheses. Now you can use literal for any type. When you're describing a type, it is enough to specify the function that converts literal to a given type using new aspects such as integer literal, real literal, or string literal. Also, you can specify a function to convert a value of a particular type to a text. Compiler will call this to implement image attribute of this type. Any predefined type now have image attribute, not just scalars. This new feature raises a lot of discussion regarding its syntax. At the same time, everyone recognizes it as a nice-to-have feature. This is a reduction in assignment operator. Sometimes it is necessary to indicate that on the right side of assignment operator, what is written to the left of the assignment sign. For example, when you do an increment. In case of latter part is very verbose, you can easily make a mistake when copying. Or later, after change one part, you can forget to change another. Therefore, shortened form is actually safer. But syntax doesn't look obvious. Now, two simple enhancements. In absence of ambiguity, you can omit a type name in renaming object or value. Delta expression or declare expression allow you to enter new identifiers in sub-expression. This eliminates coded duplication and simplifies the writing of contracts. Runtime extension. One more feature related to non-blocking execution is compare and swap operation. This operation is commonly used in creating lock-free containers. This operation puts a value at the specified address, but work only when old value is specified correctly. This implemented as generic packaging. Another operation like this is test and set. Two new packages allow you to perform operations with arbitrary precision, with integer and fractions. Besides corresponding types, packages include subtype for positive and natural values, arithmetic operation, minimum and maximum, conversion to string and back. To support real-time systems, another profile will be added. It contains weaker restrictions than existing Raven's car profile. SIGNAT compiler currently supports ADA 2020X mode. You can activate it with the dash SIGNAT 2020 option, but only a few features are implemented now. These are iterators in array aggregates, delta aggregates, and abbreviation in assignment operations. The compiler doesn't complain on global aspect, but it doesn't check it neither. As you see, there is no prototype compiler for new standard. Regarding this, given the time is running out, standardization group is seeking for comments based on prototyping and review on the new features. You can send them on email. ADA Core, in its turn, launched a GitHub repository when you can share your ideas and take part in discussions of the language. That's all for me. Thank you.